me show you what we're doing tonight, y'all. Now that we've got all that. So, I've got these little snowflakes, you guys. Well, they're not little. And I want to make a trivet out of it. And I'm going to use the color coal black on here because I'm going to make it kind of a rustic snowflake. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to get some paint on this big old Walmart brush here. Okay, not too much. My husband would say not too much. I'm just going to kind of dab some of it off because I don't want to get in between the lines. I don't want to do that part because it's tedious and it takes a very long time. And it's not necessary because I think it might give it a little dimension and make it look even better if I don't do that. So I'm just going to kind of almost dry brush this, if you will, and just going to go in like this and give it with Fusion Mineral Paint and the coal black. And I'm going to just get in here and paint it black. Mop it up with paint. I just got it almost just stained with the paint, okay? Because I'm going to go over it with this crackle medium. And I'm going to grab one of my smaller brushes because I don't need a great big one for this. And I'm just going to get in here and put some of this crackle finish all over. It's clear. But what happens when you put the next layer on is it starts its little magic. Does a little magic trick for you. Crackle finish. You don't have to. Question. You can get this crackle finish at Hobby Lobby. You can get it on Amazon. I'm not even sure. Walmart might carry it. It's by Folk Art. So it looks like this now. Okay, it's got a little bright, you know, not real lightweight. So I'm going to go ahead with this creamy, dreamy raw silk. Let's call another brush over here, like the last one. Just dip it in some water quickly, wet it just a bit, and here's where the magic comes in. You just get in there with your brush. I'm going to start from the inside and go out and put a nice coat of raw silk, kind of smooth it out, and the magic starts happening like almost instantly. You don't want to go over it once it starts to crackle. You want to let it be. Ta-da! And you can see all that crackle in there. What I'm going to do is I'm going to dry it. I love that so much. All right, bling time. Yes, it's blinging time. I've got a snowflake right here, and it is in gold. And I want it to lay nice and flat on this so that when somebody lays something down on it, it's going to hold up, you know? And I'm going to bling some of the edges here with some of my TD bling here. Right here. And pour them all out. Get my picker pin. There we go. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to just do just a few coming out from the center of the snowflake here. I think I'm going to just do, oh, I don't know, maybe six or so in each spot. And then I'll put some along this part here. Let's see, I'm going to have one, two, three, four, five, six, seven. If I have enough, I don't want to use too many. One, two, three, four, five, six. I think what I'll do is I'll start them out bigger and then I'll graduate them skinnier going down, like, you know, little poofs of light. That will look cool. So let me get my other stones out, the SS16, which is, it said two is the SS16, right? Show you. See how pretty that shows up? That you can see there's color in it. Kind of like when you look at snow, it looks, it glistens and it's just got some colors in it. And, you know, it's like a little diamond, you know? So anyway, that's what I'm doing here. All right. From this side, I'm going to do six more of the big ones. And voila. Six of these. You know. It ain't bling unless it's totally dazzled here. There we go. Isn't that beautiful already? But I want to put this on first. I want to line up these holes where I took the... These were supposed to be hung, apparently. But I'm going to, and I kind of like that it's not painted on the inside there. Kind of like that a little bit. But anyway, I'm going to put some of these wood beads that I got from a garland that I've had. And what I like to do is I like to put the, because there's holes in them. So what I like to do is I like to put the B7000 around the hole like that. Okay, and then I like to fill the hole with hot glue like this. Just fill it, because what's going to happen when you turn it upside down? It's going to stick. It's gonna grab hold. Okay, let's give it a second. See, that's what I'm going to do. Where they're going to connect here, I'm going to go where all these are going to connect. I'm going to put a bead. I'd have some glue strings, but we're good. And I don't have it on high either, so that's probably not good. And here we go. We're just gonna kind of sandwich it together. Yeah. Bye, George. I think she's got it. How pretty is that, right? How pretty. Ta-da! And then it's got the wood beads all the way around. Now, like I said, you could paint yours if you want them painted. So what I am going to do here is up here, up top, I'm going to add some more of the SS20, the top of these. Because it has to be the SS20 because it's got to be big enough to fit over that little hole right there. Okay, I think I got it. All right, SS20, dab there, dab there. Looky, looky, looky what I got here. Isn't that gorgeous? I love the crackle. I love all of that. I love the sparkle and the crackle, and I love that it's sandwiched between those pretty little beads like that. It's just different, right? Just different. Pretty. Ta-da!
Totally Dazzled sells sparkling rhinestone wedding supplies. Check us out at totallydazzled.com. But before you do, click up here and download our free printable sparkle quotes. Or click down here and watch one of our other awesome tutorials.